Good morning. Welcome to morning prayer. Let all the earth acclaim God. Sing to the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God, our Savior, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. The Jubilate. O shout to the Lord in triumph all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his face with songs of joy. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Come into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his holy name. For the Lord is good. His loving mercy is forever. His faithfulness throughout all generations. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us in your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Set us free from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 30 and 32.
Psalm 30. I will exalt you, O Lord, because you have lifted me up and have not let my enemies triumph over me.
O Lord, my God, I cried out to you, and you restored me to health.
You brought me up, O Lord, from the dead. You restored my life as I was going down to the grave.
Sing to the Lord, you servants of his. Give thanks for the remembrance of his holiness.
For his wrath endures but the twinkling of an eye, his favor for a lifetime.
Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning.
While I felt secure, I said, I shall never be disturbed. You, Lord, with your favor, made me as strong as the mountains.
Then you hid your face, and I was filled with fear.
I cried to you, O Lord. I pleaded with the Lord, saying,
what profit is there in my blood if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you or declare your faithfulness?
Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. O Lord, be my helper.
You have turned my wailing into dancing. You have put off my sackcloth and clothed me with joy.
Therefore, my heart sings to you without ceasing. O Lord my God, I will give you thanks forever.
Psalm 32.
Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven, and whose sin is put away.
Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, and in whose spirit there is no guile.
While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long.
For your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up as in the heat of summer.
Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not conceal my guilt.
I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord. Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin.
Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in the time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them.
You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance.
I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eyes.
Do not be like horse or mule, which have no understanding, which must be fitted with bit and bridle, or else they will not stay near you.
Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord.
Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Shout for joy, all who are true of heart.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. A reading from the Word of God, taken from the book of Sirach, chapter 15, verses 9 to 20. Praise is unseemly on the lips of a sinner, for it has not been sent from the Lord. For in wisdom must praise be uttered, and the Lord will make it prosper. Do not say, it was the Lord's doing that I fell away, for he does not do what he hates. Do not say, it was he who led me astray, for he has no need of the sinful. The Lord hates all abominations, Such things are not loved by those who fear him. It was he who created humankind in the beginning, and he left them in the power of their own free choice. If you choose, you can keep the commandments, and to act faithfully is a matter of your own choice. He has placed before you fire and water. Stretch out your hand for whichever you choose. Before each person are life and death, and whichever one chooses will be given. For great is the wisdom of the Lord. He is mighty in power and sees everything. His eyes are on those who fear him, and he knows every human action. He has not commanded anyone to be wicked, and he has not given anyone permission to sin. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears, and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you all the days of our lives. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 11, verses 1 to 13. He was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us, and do not bring us to the time of trial.' And he said to them, 'Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say to him, "Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him." And he answers from within, "Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything." I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given you. Search, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks, receives, and everyone who searches, finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you, if your child asks for a fish, you will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Do you remember when you were taught to pray, what you were taught to say, or the stance you held, meaning the position that you were in? It might be a little far, but when you consider what you've done for your children, or the way children are taught to pray, some in their beds at night, hands clasped, eyes closed, some kneeling at the side of their beds when they go to, before they go to sleep or when they awake at morning. But the position you were taught was usually a position of reverence, of humility, of reminding yourself that God is above and you are lower than He is. And I wanted us to think about that. Now I want us to think about how we position ourselves to pray now. And I know for many of us, we would have some sort of justification. My knees, so I can't bend anymore. Well, I usually sit in a chair because, you know, I make myself comfortable and then I talk to my God. And the list goes on. But somewhere in our transition, we lost the depth and meaning of why we pray, of what is prayer, of our connection. And so we feel that the hurried things we do, short things we do, or the continuous talk and request is us praying. The disciples recognized that there was something important about prayer. Something important about prayer. And they wanted to know how to do it. Not just randomly, but understand depth. Understand the correct way, understand what is required of them. And Jesus talks as though it's amazingly simple. You begin with my Father in heaven. You know, we bypass it. We know it by heart and we just run through. Our Father who art in heaven, I'll be in it, like you can come and trespasses and notice you ain't get half the words inside of there. So we're losing the essence, we're losing depth. And for some of us, we never knew the meaning. We just knew we say this prayer because this is what Jesus said to do. This is what He taught His disciples. But I first remind us that they made a request. And He says, our Father who art in heaven. That puts a distance between us and God. Not that God is far, but understanding then that we're not on the same play field. We're not in the same position. We're not in the same realm of understanding. God and us. Mommy and Daddy, you come to share with Dad or Mom, and I know some of us will say they never had that, but you've seen and you've watched movies. We're adults, a lot of us, we're adults, and so we have reason and we can make adjustments. We're not holding to past, but we're looking to a change and understanding. And so a child comes to have this conversation with his father or his mother or this guardian that is in charge, granny even, and granny says, how are you? How was your day? And you start sharing, or the child starts sharing in this appreciative manner, this humble embrace, this love, not a stance or position of lordship that we tend to hold as though God is our servant rather than the reverse. Our Father, that's the authoritative position. Who art in heaven, that is the distance. Hallowed be your name. Your name be praised. Your name is higher than all names. You understand what I'm saying, my brothers and sisters in Christ? This alone guides us to understanding the might, power, awesome authority of God above us, above us. Even though he wants to connect with us. But it is about us understanding that relationship, understanding that authority, and then aligning that with our prayer presentation. Not prayer request, presentation. So in that conversation, yes, prayer, conversation, communion, relationship with God, it is understood we're not the ones in charge. That's very important for us to understand. It is important for us to understand we're not the one in charge. And so we're coming to God humble. We're coming to God with an understanding of his might and power, his sovereignty. Even Jesus, when he went away to the garden, come away for prayer, come away for that connection with God the Father. He too humbled himself before God. Look at the prayer where he said in Gethsemane, Lord, if it is your will. What? If it is your will. So in that, he's still looking to God for direction. When he talks about he's about his Father's business, he's still holding to the authority that is God. And I want us to understand that I'm going through it and I'm repeating it and I'm saying it slowly, because too long have we lost our way in our connection with God. We feel that singing the song that makes us feel good is us praying twice or praising twice, as it says, and that's enough. I didn't say it wasn't. I said we feel that that's enough. But in our communication with God, prayer is about us having a relationship with God. Relationships require work. Relationships require attention. Relationship requires open communication. Relationship requires listening. And that's what I want us to get from all of it. The prayer continues, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Not my will, but yours, God. Not my will, but yours. And so we realize further as we delve into the Lord's Prayer how direct it is. There's so many other things happening before we get to our petitions. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day. See how far that was, right? See how far that was. We had a whole section go before we started to make a request. Give us today, this day, our daily bread. Forgive us. So we are looking now at us asking for forgiveness for the sins that we would have committed. And of course, there's a condition, as much as we forgive others. So there is the reminder that we must forgive others if we intend to be forgiven. And I want us to hold to that right there. A lot of us feel that, well, God will forgive me. Even if I don't forgive that one, God will forgive me. But look at your prayers. How can you want for yourself what you don't want for anybody else? Do unto others. You want God to show you. God wants us to live for a life of forgiveness, a life of love. And if we have that love, we would forgive others. But yet we're still making this excuse that I can't forgive it. It was too much. It was too hard. Yet we go to God with our petitions. We go to God with our cares. We go to God with our requests and desires. And we want God to fulfill all of that. But we're not doing all of what He wants us to do. And I want us to be aware of that in our prayers. And this, and you know, you understand now why. Well, one of the reasons, because a lot of it has to do with our faith, our belief in God and who is this God to us, our understanding of who this God is to us. And when we don't work on that understanding, when we don't work on that relationship with God, then our faith is low. And so when we pray, then we don't believe and it does not get answered. At least not right away, or in the way God wants to answer. You know, friends in Christ, I want us to really understand what prayer is. It is not random communication with God. It is not babbling over and over. It is about us being very pointed, very specific. It is about us being humble. It is about us understanding who God is and who we are. And so strive for that relationship with the Creator and creation. Strive for that open communication that He wants from us, where we can take all of our burdens to Him. But not only our burdens, but more so acknowledging who He is, understanding who He is, so that as we bring our burdens, we leave it with Him, understanding He will take care of it. He is mighty and powerful. He is our Father, our God, who is able. Yeah? And of course, the prayer continues with the thanksgiving. With thanksgiving, and then ends with supplication. It sounds like the Acts, right? But it's not as direct or simple as that, but really broken down so that we understand. We praise God. We spend so much time complaining, we forget to praise God. We forget to adore God. We forget to acknowledge God. We forget to call God out on who He is. And for a lot of us, we allow the world and life to bog us down that we don't even know who God is. Yet, we're still there, focused on, I want. My brothers and sisters in Christ, let us adjust a little bit. And that's the whole point of it. Let us adjust a bit the way we communicate with God. And for some of us, we may need to hold a position of reverence. Yes, we can pray everywhere, anytime, all the time. But holding a physical position reminds us, see why we have to go on our knees. It reminds us how little we are and how big God is. It reminds us that we're not the ones in charge. We're not to be served, but to serve. And in remembering that, in understanding that, and engaging that, our responses to God will be different. And look how far toward each other will be different. Because we will come to know that God is mighty and we are all equal. He's not our equal, but we are equal to each other. And in understanding that, I'm not going to try to be bigger than you. You're not going to try to be bigger than me or more powerful than I am, or reverse. Just accept each other for being who we are, God's creation, beloved and good. So let's reconsider how we pray. Learn words of praise to God. Learn words of adoration. Learn words of acknowledgement to say, God is mighty. You are my strong tower, my Father, my King. All praise to your name. Start simple. Let's just get that part over and over. Get in a position of praise. Get in a custom of praise, acknowledging who God is. Who is this God to you? Begin there and then work your way through, just as the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Acknowledge. Speak to it. Own it. Believe it. And see how your attitude to God changes. Your appreciation for God changes. As well as your supplications before God changes. You will believe it. Amen.
Come, children. Have you forgotten the simple things of life that made us who we are? Have you missed your way? Sweet hour of prayer.
Of distress and grief, my soul often found that relief to escape their tempers and snare. My strength is the power of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, sweet hour of prayer. And since he bides me, I seek his face,
oh yeah,
believe in his words, trust in his grace, just have some faith, oh yeah,
have some faith. I cast on him my every care, my doubts, my shivers and fears. I have the courage to be anywhere and wait on the hour of prayer.
Sweet hour of prayer. Hour of prayer, oh, sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, sweet hour of prayer, from our world of care, the power of prayer.
Let us confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. Almighty and everlasting God, in Christ you have revealed your glory among the nations. Preserve the works of your mercy, that your church throughout the world may persevere with steadfast faith in the confession of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us to your service, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God, our Father, you have bidden light to shine out of darkness and have awakened us again to praise you and your goodness and to seek your grace. Make us children of light and of the day, that our lives being open to your glory, we may shine as lights in the world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. Almighty God, you have promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in your Son's name. We pray that what we have asked faithfully, we may obtain effectually. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons, in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful weekend, everyone. God bless you.